to get in some worship. I know I am. How about you, Mr. Cheeto Bag? I'm ready too. Yeah, they're still ready for this. Who's getting ready? All right, let's get warmed up. Let's jump side to side for starters. Make sure you got your Christmas lights with you. Oh, I'm punching Cheetos everywhere. Oh no, no, no. All right, let's start out with some warm-ups. Ready? Let's get a little one worship pan single. One, okay, now another one to go. Two, now one, two, one, two. Cheeto break. Feel the music. Feel it flow through your veins. Feel the spirit from within. Don't leave anything to chance. Cheeto time, go. Bring your knees up like this. Now a little bit faster. Somebody call my doctor.
Break every chain. Jingle bells in the my name's Charles and I'm about to build a gingerbread house made of graham crackers.
Hey! All right!
The Church Kids Show!
Welcome back to the Church Kids Show, Christmas edition!
Yeah! Today is a very big day!
Why?
Because it's my favorite day of the year ever in the whole year!
What? Why?
Well, because today is the day that we make gingerbread houses!
Okay.
But with graham crackers. All right, here we go. Let's get started.
Wait. Let's at least say our faith declaration first.
All right. Gosh, I almost forgot.
Yes, clearly.
Well, our faith declaration this month is God has a plan for my life.
Excellent. Okay, Charles, now we can make gingerbread houses.
Finally!
But let's make it a competition. Church Kids, make sure you go and vote on Champion Center Church Kids Instagram and tell us whose gingerbread house you like best.
Made of graham crackers.
Yes, ginger, graham cracker.
Graham cracker house.
Christmas house. Gingerbread.
Graham bread house.
So in front of us, we have graham crackers. We have an assortment of candies, including these minion graham crackers.
Those are minions?
Yeah.
I thought they were bats.
Nope, minions.
You ate him.
Okay, I'm going to.
You know what, I'm just gonna lay my foundation now. I need my cement.
Okay, what we're gonna not try to do is shake the whole table while we.
But this table is unstable. What else am I supposed to do, huh?
I have decided to place some snow on my plate like so.
It's already falling over. Wait. Idea. I'll create little pillars. Keep it steady.
Oh, this frosting smells so good.
No, we only have spoons. That's our only tool. Just like we couldn't use scissors in the turkey game. Graham cracker is not gingerbread.
Bad news.
Graham cracker is not gingerbread. Oh, I really want to make a gingerbread house made of graham crackers.
The Church Kids Show! Would you ever actually live in a gingerbread house?
No.
You had the opportunity.
No.
Really?
Yeah. I live in Washington and insulation would be terrible with gingerbread as walls.
Okay, yeah. But I mean like for just like a season.
An entire season? Oh my gosh, no. Summer would all fall apart.
All right, church kids, this is taking quite a while because we are creating masterpieces.
Sure thing.
So we're gonna head on over, check out what game we have for you today.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, church kids. What's up? It's me, Teacher Jeremiah's, dressed as a Christmas tree, because guess what? We're here again today for another holiday game time. Woo! Okay, for this holly jolly game time, what you're gonna need is a nice big round bowl and six candy canes. Six candy canes, don't eat the candy canes. Okay, to play this game, you will need to grab one of the six candy canes and put the flat end into your mouth, like this. With the end of the candy cane, you're gonna pick up the rest of the candy canes and put them in the bowl. You only have 60 seconds to do that. Each player who can do this in under 60 seconds will get awarded some points. Are you ready to play this game? If you're ready, we can start in 3, 2, 1, go!
The time has come to feast your eyes on our final product. Are you ready?
Yes! 3, 2, 1. I chose to go with a longhouse because I like space. And I'm minimalistic.
I decided to go with the longhouse as well on the bottom, but then I added another floor for, you know, guests and stuff.
Is your restroom
like
up here?
A sitting room with some video games or whatever. And then up here, yeah, it's like the lookout tower into Gingerbread Land.
See, I only had one person building, and so they didn't have as big of a budget to go to a third story.
So yeah, we had two down here.
Don't forget
Sylvia and Franklin.
Smoke coming from the chimney.
Mine has a cobblestone path leading up to the door.
Well, mine has gumdrops to stabilize the wall, so mine's gonna be strong. If you were to poke this with 1 newton of power, I'm sure it wouldn't fall. Whereas that one, I don't know.
This is excellent.
So, and I have chocolate chips in my yard.
All right, church kids, head on over to...
And a red snake.
Head on over to Instagram and make sure you vote on whose gingerbread house you think is the best.
Well, it is that time of day.
Memory verse time! time.
Oh, I was going to say that it's time for my afternoon nap.
What? No way. We have so much more to do.
Okay, you're right. But I ate a lot of candy while making this gingerbread graham cracker house, because it's not gingerbread. And now I'm really full. And when I get really full, I get kind of tired. And when I get tired, I get sleepy.
Okay. Anyway, church kids, are you ready to practice our memory verse?
All right. This one's for Jeremiah 29:11. Here we go.
Jeremiah 29:11.
Woo!
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord.
Sing it again. Come on.
Jeremiah 29:11.
Yep.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord.
Plans to what?
Plans to prosper you.
Prosper. Prosper.
Not to harm you.
Not to harm you, but
plans to give you hope and a future.
He's got plans for you. It's time to see them. We're giving it up. I got to breathe in. Prosperity isn't his plan for you to bring out on it and dance for. I'm believing God for good things in my future. Harm will not come after me. This is God's chapter. So throw it out, the thought that says bad things about you. Yeah, it's a lie that. Truth be told, the plan for you is a good one. Handpicked plan from the man, the real son. Read the word, know that that's your weapon. Take a stand, know your plans from heaven. Say again the verse that forms this lesson. Say Jeremiah 29:11.
Oh, Jeremiah.
Jeremiah.
Oh, Jeremiah.
29:11. Woo!
For I know the plans I have for you.
Jeremiah 29:11.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord.
Plans to what?
Plans to prosper you.
Prosper, prosper.
Not to harm you.
Not to harm you, but
plans to give you hope and a future.
We out.
Church kids, it's time to jump into today's lesson.
Alrighty, Tracy, but do you know what time it is?
What? I just said it's time to jump into today's lesson. We're going to continue learning about the true Christmas story.
Yeah. But first, I have to keep reading you my story, remember?
Oh, yeah. Honestly, I can't remember where we left off last week.
Well, last week on The Church Kids Show, I decided to write my own version of the Christmas story and I started to read it to you. Here's what happened. Two wise men and one wise woman named Stephen, Ronald, and Carly, and one tired camel named Frank were on a journey following the star, but they got lost. They were fighting and arguing and blaming each other, and then they met us, Charles and Tracy, and we told them about Jeremiah 29:11, which says, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a hope and a future." The wise men realized that God had a plan for them and they just needed to trust him and keep following the star. And just when they left, Charles and Tracy heard a knock and the sound of a sheep at the door.
Right. So are we gonna find out who was at the door?
Yep.
Are we gonna find out today?
Oh, yeah, of course. Sorry. Where was I? Page. Don't even go back to my. I already did my recap of it and all of them. Oh no, our little paper peoples. There we go. Okay. Ah, yes. Here we are. So Charles and Tracy heard a loud knock on the door.
Did I just hear someone knock at our door?
Did I just hear a sheep?
Oh. Yo. Hey guys.
What's up?
My name's Tim.
It's my brother Hank. We're shepherds.
We're the shepherds.
Yeah. I was wondering if we could come in and warm up because it's kind of freezing outside.
It's true.
Man, everyone's just showing up tonight.
Yeah, and did I miss some sort of memo that I should be wearing like robes? Because it seems that everyone's kind of doing that right now.
Come on in and warm up, I guess, since you're already here.
Where are you guys headed on such a cold night?
Well, I mean, it's kind of a long story.
You see, it all started when we were sitting out in the field watching over our sheep. Mm. Then?
Well, actually, it started 3 weeks before that when our dad decided that it was time for us to stop goofing around and actually start working. But the problem is, I didn't want to be a shepherd. Our family has been doing this for generations. Seriously.
Our great, 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 great grandparents started the farm we work at.
Yup. Anyways, now it's our turn to take over the family business, but let me tell you, sitting out there in the field all day long staring at sheep is super boring.
Yep.
So anyway, we were just watching sheep, and then all of a sudden, a super bright light appeared. It was seriously so bright. And the angel said, "Hey, wake up, it's me, the angel of the Lord." Dude, and we totally freaked out, and we were like, "Ah! What is going on? Where is this bright light in my eyes? Who is that strange person?" And then the angel said, "Whoa, whoa, whoa, calm down. I've got a message for you. Today, this guy Jesus was born and I need you to go see him."
And then all of a sudden, a bunch of other angels showed up and they started singing. And then they were just gone. And then we kind of just sat there for a minute.
So, we decided to listen to the angels and start our journey to find this guy, Jesus. But I'm not sure where even we were going.
Yep, we've been wandering around forever, and it seems like we are never going to get there.
Honestly, this isn't how I expected to be spending my weekend.
This isn't really how I was expecting to spend my life.
Whoa, this just got, like, surprisingly deep.
Dude, I'm just saying. I didn't think I was gonna be a shepherd, and now I'm a shepherd who's following the advice of some random glowing guy that shows up, just wandering around on a super long journey to meet some other random guy named Jesus.
Yeah, and I'm tired. My feet are tired, my hands are tired, oh, my face okay. is
well,
tired.
Funny enough, we were just talking to some people about how God has a plan for our life.
Yep, but sometimes that plan is not our plan.
Yeah, for instance. So one time before I had a car, I wanted to visit my friend, but they lived really far away. So my plan was to use city transportation. I took 3 trains, 2 buses to get to them, and I did, and it was great. But when it was time to go home, I tried it. Turned out my bus card was now empty, so the bus driver wouldn't let me on the bus, and then I didn't have enough money to put on my card, so I ran 1 mile to a bank that closed moments before I got there, but then I saw a police officer driving around. I asked him if he could give me a ride. At first he said no, and then I asked again, and then he said yes, and I said thank you, and he took me to the nearest train station, but my credit card wasn't working to buy me a ticket, so then I ran around for 30 minutes asking people for change to help me buy my train ticket, and then I got the money to make it home, but all together took me around 5 hours to make it 20 miles home, which was not part of my plan.
I mean, that wasn't the best example, but you get the point. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a hope and a future." God has a plan, but sometimes, if not a lot of times, the plan God has for our lives isn't at all what we thought it would be.
That's right. There might be some moments where you are unsure, feel disqualified, or have questions, but your best life is found in God's plan. Maybe you didn't think you would be a shepherd. And maybe you didn't think that an angel would come to you and tell you to go find Jesus. But it was part of God's plan, and it will be worth it in the end.
Man, I am feeling totally rejuvenated right now.
Yeah, I don't know what rejuvenated means, but
me too. Hey, thanks for reminding us that God has a plan for our lives.
Yeah.
We're gonna head out and go try to find this Jesus guy.
Yeah, thanks guys. We'll see you later.
Bye. You know what, Charles?
What?
Everybody seems to be headed to see this Jesus guy. Do you think we should go too?
I mean, I guess so. Even though it's really cold out there.
Come on, Charles. Where's your adventuresome spirit? Let's go!
And that's all I've written, so you're gonna have to wait to hear the rest next week.
Charles, that story was really good. I loved how you talked about God having a plan, but sometimes that plan is not our plan. Should we watch the true story of the shepherds now?
Yeah.
This is Jesus.
Hoo-yah!
Jesus is the Son of God who would grow up to do amazing things. His parents on earth were Mary
Hi.
And Joseph.
Hey-o.
Jesus was born in a barn because there was no room for him anywhere else in Bethlehem. On the night Jesus was born, there were some shepherds in the field keeping watch over their sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them. And a bright light shone all around them. The shepherds were so scared, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid.
Okay.
I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David."
Whoa, what?
The angel told the shepherds that they would find Jesus in a barn wrapped in strips of cloth, laying in a manger.
Okay.
Then the angel was joined by many, many other angels, and all of them sang, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." Then the angels returned to heaven.
What just happened?
And the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem."
Yeah.
So they hurried to the village.
You stay there.
And found the baby Jesus laying in the manger.
Wow!
After seeing Jesus, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had told them about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard the shepherd's story were amazed. Mary made sure she remembered all these things and thought about them often. Then the shepherds went back to their sheep and praised God for all they had seen. The baby was exactly who the angel had told them he was, the Savior of the world, the Son of God.
Now, I'm just saying, my story was pretty close to that.
I mean, kinda. It's amazing how God had such a big plan for those shepherds. I bet that was the last thing that they were expecting.
Hey, church kids, my name is Buddy the Elf, and I'm here to give you today's rapid recap. This month, we're learning all about the true story of Christmas. Christmas! Every time I say it, I just get excited. This week, we learned all about the shepherds. Even though the story Charles wrote wasn't the exact story in the Bible, it taught us a great lesson that God's plan is not always the same as our plan, but His plan is the best plan. Man, that's hard to say. Anyway, God had a big plan for the shepherds, and God has a big plan for you. It might not look what you have planned, but trust me, His plan is the best plan. I'll see you next week for our rapid recap. But until then, eat your candy canes, candy corn, and your syrup. Oh, hey, Mr. Narwhal, wait.
Well, church kids, it has been a blast hanging out with you today and learning more about the story of Christmas.
Yes, it has. Don't forget to head on over to Instagram and vote for my gingerbread house as the winner.
What?
Well,
hello?
Okay. We will see you next week, and don't forget, it's a great day
to be a church kid!
Yay! Yeah, yeah, yeah.